Right, so here we are again for the third episode of my Kerbal Space Program career mode playthrough, where today we are going to build some high altitude and suborbital research rockets, unmanned ones. As I have told in the last episode, which was 90 in-game days ago, because of the long time it currently takes to research some stuff. But, yeah, first of all, let's head into the mission control and take on to the first flight mission here, which comes from the, how was it called, the Career Evolution Contract Pack. And if we look through this, what we also can do today is escape the atmosphere, which is from the Kerbin's World First Record Keeping Society, so like the Guinness Book of Records. So let's accept this one and head into the VAB. So here we still can see from the last mission, which I did not record, this Stay Putnik probe core with a heat shield and swivel engine, because I took a contract to test these two parts at the launch pad. But it is not really worth recording to do recording of doing some stuff like this. So let's build a new vessel. And my idea is to at first take the Science Junior. There it is. Yeah, this is some kind of. Well, the description looks like a children's toy, some my first scientist kit, but it gives a really nice amount of science points, especially if you recover it. So that's what we are going to do. And in order to do so, we need a probe core. And it's better to take the Octo for a number of reasons. And of course we want to recover this whole thing. So let's put this parachute on top, a radial attaching one. Not this one, because we still need this attachment point. In order to build some kind of, or make it a little bit less an aerodynamic. So let's move this thing down like this. Stage these two parts together. And let's see if you also have a... Yes, we do have it. How is it called? Service bay, where we can build some, or where we can put some more science experiments inside. Take another decoupler. We can also stage these two things together, and also give it a little engine at first, because the first one will not even be some high altitude, because with the Career Evolution contract pack, there also is a contract, we won't need spare parts. There also is a contract which includes reaching the upper atmosphere. So, let's see, we did not have the blood sample before. And always keep an eye on the part count. We did not have this, whatever it is, before. We did not have the skin sample before, which also is, there goes my phone, also is from the Kraken Science mod. And let's also take this one, and that one, and the eye sample, and we already have the blood sample. Maybe we will splash down, I don't know. see. Yeah, I think that's all the experiments that we can take. So let's close it. How long will it then take to build? 27 days. Did we forget anything? No, we did not. So let's... Ah yes, we need a valid name. Science Junior 1, because the first episode I think marked the end of the untitled spacecraft program. So let's build it. Okay, let's leave. Do not save. Remove the alarm. One we won't need anymore, and warp to complete. Okay, and roll it out again, remove the alarm and warp to complete, and let's launch it. Okay, so here we are. Staging looks good. For science is active because we will need it. No, where is it? That's weird. Anyway, let's see if for science is active. Activate SAS. This is the reason I chose the Octo probe core instead of the Stay Putnik, because the Stay Putnik does not have SAS. So SAS is active, staging looks good. And let's go. That was not supposed to happen. So let's do all the experiments. There goes my phone again. Landing spot marker from the Kerbal Engineer mod shows us that we are not going to crash land. So this how was it called? The oceanography experiment from, I don't even know what mod it is from, was completely unnecessary. But anyway, I think this is a nice amount of science that we have collected. Time warp a bit. Now we are heading more into the direction of missions, or the style of missions that I like to do. It's not good yet, but it's not as bad as the first flights. So here we have landed, and let's recover the vessel, recover to VAB because we will fly it right again. And we have collected 67 science points from only flying low. So the next launch, which will hit the upper atmosphere, will do even better. think to speed things up, first of all, we have two upgrade points to spend, which we will put one point at the VAV and one point at the research and development department. Speaking of the research and development department, we can already start to research some of the next stuff, which will be, let's see, the general rocketry, because we need the Sumper SLB for, I don't know why there's two pieces, but we will need the Sumper SLB for the first orbit, for our first satellite, which will be not the next episode, but like the second next one, the one that comes after the next episode. And we will also need the general construction for that one. Advanced rocketry we will only need for some of the later satellites and for the first manned orbit. But speaking of the first manned orbit, I like to do some more plane flying first, as like pretending to be it would be pilot training. Or pretending that it would be pilot training. So we will need that one. And I think we cannot even do more than 100 science points on the level 1 research and development department, so we definitely need some funds. And yeah, but we only have 30 science points left anyway, so we cannot do much with them. So oh, this will take ages. So let's warp to complete of this one and edit it. And so what we will do now is at first do the same kind of, or add the same kind of aerodynamic thing like we did before. And again, add a solid rocket motor, but now also add a second one in order to actually reach the upper atmosphere. These two will be staged together, and we are at 17 of 30 parts, so we still can add some aerodynamic fins in order to keep it stable, and some smaller ones up here, or maybe more like this, I don't know, like this. And we still have a lot of space left for experiments, or not only a lot of space, but we also a lot of parts. We can add 7 pieces. So let's take the mystery goo and the other two. Is it the other two stock experiments and I think the, was it the photometer and the gas analyzer? Yes, we also did before in the lower atmosphere. Here and the photometer there, and can we add the microwave oven? Yes, we can. And the sample box, think it is complete now, yep. Had 30 of 30 parts, perfect. So let's close. Looking good. And it will be the mission Science Junior 2. So let's save edits. It will take 11 days to build. No. And warp to complete. And before we launch, we can take the. We have. Let's see, I think we can only take one contract at a time. So this would be that one. But anyway, with breaking the sound barrier, it would be perfect for the next video that I have in mind, which is a manned rocket plane. So let's just take the upper atmosphere contract. Yeah, we cannot accept more than what we have already. So let's roll it out. Warp to complete, and let's launch it. So, double check the staging, everything looks fine, activate SAS, and go. I will not stage right now, because if I stage now, I'm afraid it might go into space. So let's wait until... Oh, this is not good. This is not good. I can see a problem, we run out of electricity. So let's revert to launch. And what we will do now is once that we we are on the right course, I will set the probe core into hibernation mode, so it will use much less electricity. And I will stage immediately, because obviously the rocket is still not stable enough to reach space. So let's activate SAS. Let's go. Activate hibernation, keep a close eye on our resources, deactivate SAS. Does not reach the upper atmosphere, but anyway, we can do quite a lot of science again. and deploy the parachute before we run out of electricity. And so what we have to do next in order to actually reach the upper atmosphere and eventually even reach space is just add or replace solid motors with bigger ones. Let's hide it. I think what we can do now is also collect it is not underwater. Anyway, let's recover before we run out of battery. Again, run out, recover to VAB. And we have collected 76 science points. So let's see what we can do with them. Is landing. We won't need that one soon. Advanced flight control. We won't need either. Space exploration. Also not. But miniaturization for the first satellite. Electrics. Oh, we don't have enough science points. So, anyway. I think we have to wait for the general rocketry to be complete in 28 days. Yeah, I think we have it, so let's head back into the VAB. Cleanse, close. No. I think we have to leave again. VAB. Let's edit. And again, add this not very aerodynamic nose. Move it down. And now instead of play. What is going on? Instead of placing the small flea solid rocket booster, we will place the big hammer. And underneath it, we will place the even bigger thumper. Quite useless, so instead we will take a battery with us. So let's close that one and again add 3 fins per stage. 3 big ones, this Delta Deluxe winglet that are controllable, and 3 smaller ones the upper stage. Save edits. And wait for 2 days. VAB warp to complete. Oh, we are already ready. I was typing something on my phone in the meantime. So let's... Oh, it's ready to launch. What was I doing? So let's launch it. SAS is on, staging looks good. Let's keep an eye on our electricity. And yeah, let's go. Oh dear, of course. We ready? Doing this. And will it reach 18 kilometers? No, it will not. 18,300 meters. Oh, maybe it will. Maybe it will. Yep, it does. So let's quickly perform all the experiments that we have before we drop down again. So we have reached the upper atmosphere, and I think. Yep, contract complete. This one we will keep. And we can throw our parachute. So let's time warp a little again. Something. Where is our parachute? That was close. always check your staging. And here we go, but we cannot do any science anymore. But anyway, I'm quite confident that we have collected a lot of it. So let's recover. Recover to VAB as usual. And we have collected 145 science points. Let's see. So for the next launch, we will have to sacrifice two parts or two experiments. And one of them will be the sample box, and the other one will be the temperature scan, because the temperature scan I'm quite sure we will do again sooner or later, or we will get the chance to do it again sooner or later. So let's take the Kármán line contract, because now we are headed to space for the first time in Kerbal. Stupid me went directly to the VAB again instead of where is it? Here it is, going to the VAB menu. Still takes some time to recover, so let's time warp a little. Instead of going here and editing it. So what did we say? The sample box is this one. This one has to go, and the thermometer has to go. And again. The aerodynamic nose, and now we will add the flea booster, the hammer booster, and Sampa booster. Check the staging. Good. Next up will be this two, and then this three. Add the stability fins here and there. And perhaps we should add a reaction wheel. Yeah, this one is the hydrometer, so we will have to sacrifice one more experiments and the reaction wheel. And also our part count, 30 of 30. So good, let's move this not so aerodynamic nose down. Close this service bay, save the edits, and wait 2 days for the vessel to be complete. And roll it out, which takes about 1 hour. And I think we will launch in the morning for this very historic flight. Or a little bit historic. I think the first satellite will be more historic, and then especially the first Kerbal in space, and then the first moon landings and so on. But anyway, and of course it has to stay stable, and I'm not sure if it will. So let's just activate SAS, check the staging, and then better get ready to I think the battery will last. Why are you so unstable? And I mean, I know theoretically how to build rockets. Perhaps I just should have cared more about it, especially about the aerodynamics. Okay, let's revert to VAB. This doesn't help. So I think we will have to sacrifice some more of course we have to sacrifice some more experiments, so let's get rid of the microwave. And the first stage is stable, the second one theoretically too, but it isn't. So let's try to add one more reaction wheel and hope that it do the trick. Close. And we will have to wait. Oh wait, or can we just, because the changes are very minor, I think we can just yes, we do have successfully tricked the or successfully fooled the Kerbal construction time mod. So again, activate SAS. Let's go and hope for the best. Activate hibernation in order to save battery. Well, let's see if it will keep it safe stable by pointing directly prograde with the fin. Yeah, this looks like we are going to reach space. Not in the way that I hoped for, but we are going to reach space. Hold on, did we actually accept the Karman line contract? Where is it? Active Karman line, yes we did. And we will escape the atmosphere. As we do now, we are in space. So let's close that one. Do all our experiments and all the time that we have. And activate hibernation to save battery. It's quite boring. Photometer detected a level of 250 watts per square meter. Eye sample. Looks like the eye was ripped out. This is Kerbal style. I like it. Skin sample. But ugly feature is hidden underneath that skin. Atmospheric pressure scan. The instrument reads zero. As if it were in a vacuum. Gas analyzer scan, also zero. Tentacle sample. Do you know where the sample came from? Mystery goo. It has clumped into a sphere. Of course, because it is in weightlessness. And it has, it appears to have become quite brittle. Blood sample. The first blood sample is 20 years old, so I guess it is all black now. And the material study. The microgravity has greatly affected the growth of the crystalline structures. Loose objects are also flying around the bay in a very messy but fascinating way. Okay. So let's stage away these two pieces of junk. And behold, Kerbin from space. The only problem we are facing now is that we are literally slamming into the atmosphere in a few seconds. And we do not have a heat shield. So I don't know if at least the lower part will survive re-entry. And I think all the data still is stored inside the experiments themselves. This is not good. This is not good at all. How much funds do we have, by the way? Yeah, this is a nice advance. So fingers crossed to survive re-entry. Getting hot. Does the heat say? Oh, it looks good. Something. Ah, the aerodynamic nose cone broke apart because of G-forces. But I think we are going to. No, we are not going to land in the mountains. This is good news, because in the mountains there would be the danger of the this, it's not really a spacecraft, it's more like an experiment capsule rolling down the hills. So let's time warp a little. Where are we going to land? Show, it's looking good. Hide. Okay. We have successfully landed after the first space flight. So let's see how much science we have collected. But I know that it is a lot. First of all, I think we got some nice... We have freed space, 16,000 funds. Yeah, it's looking nice. So let's recover. And do the normal recovery, because we won't do any Science Junior missions. Maybe we will do some at a later point, but for now we won't do Science Junior missions anymore. So we have collected 140 science. This is not bad. We get 17,000 funds. And yeah, I think this will that is a nice conclusion to the third episode of my Kerbal Space Program videos. And yeah, after this or just after this episode, the next one will be breaking the sound barrier, but of course with a manned aircraft. So we will see you again then, and I appreciate if you liked the video, I appreciate a like and a subscription, and you can also check out my main channel, which is linked on my channel page. So I hope to see you again in the next episode.